Good afternoon. The Prime Minister is promising to fix problems with the Medicare system after out-of-pocket GP costs hit a record high. Federal politics reporter Eliza Edwards.
After his whirlwind trip to Papua New Guinea, Anthony Albanese is back on home soil, visiting a zinc smelter in North Queensland this morning to talk up the government's plans on clean energy. But the Prime Minister was facing heat on another issue, and that is the soaring cost for Australians to see a doctor. The latest data from the Health Department shows bulk billing rates are continuing to go backwards, and when you can find a bulk billing doctor, the gap fee for a 20-minute consult is around $41. That's overtaken the $39 Medicare rebate for the first time in history. The states have warned the impact of a Medicare system in crisis is more pressure on hospitals. The PM promising reform is on his priority list.
We are putting $750 million into the primary healthcare system over just 3 years. We're working with the AMA and the Royal College to make sure that money is spent in the most effective way. Clearly, we need to look at the interaction between primary health care and our hospital system to make sure that people who shouldn't be in emergency departments can get the care that they need.
The problems within the Medicare system are set to dominate the next meeting of National Cabinet on February 1st, with New South Wales and Victoria describing it as the most important issue for them.
There was no sign of New South Wales Premier Dominic Perrottet today, with one of his ministers left to field questions about him dressing up as a Nazi for his 21st birthday. Opposition leader Chris Minns choosing not to kick along the controversy.
My sense is that it was a sincere apology and heartfelt on his behalf. I don't think it will affect the next election campaign.
What people want us to do is focus on the future, not be running through the entrails of ancient history.
The minister dismissing suggestions the Premier's own faction has been fueling the story. Queensland's opposition, meantime, has slammed Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk, labelling the youth crime crisis in the state beyond a joke. Natasha Kramer has the story.
The Queensland community is growing increasingly frustrated as car thefts and break-ins committed by children continue to rise. Reports today in the Courier Mail revealing one offender, a 15-year-old boy, is taunting authorities. The youth building a lengthy rap sheet, 80 charges but no convictions, and he's continually being let back on our streets. The opposition is pressuring the government to return back to Parliament early to get to work on reforms, calling on breach of bail to be made an offence and changing the law to allow judges and magistrates to record convictions.
Allowing judges and magistrates the ability to look at a case and decide what punishment fits the crime is what our community expects. But at the moment, they are hamstrung with weak laws. The Palaszczuk Labor government is the lawmaker. They have watered down the laws. The accountability has to sit with them.
The state government has announced a raft of reforms, including increasing the maximum sentence for car thieves, as well as increasing the penalties for those who boast about their crimes on social media.
A Queensland man has been charged with drink driving after crashing a BMW into a power pole in Logan, south of Brisbane, in the early hours of this morning. Police say the 28-year-old, who suffered minor injuries, blew 0.072 roadside. He's due to face court on Friday. Well, Victoria is in the grip of a scorching heatwave, with temperatures closing in on 40 degrees across much of the state. Penelope Lish is live in Melbourne this afternoon. Penny, a day out on the water has landed one man in hospital.
Alicia, one man has been brought here to the Alfred Hospital, flown by air ambulance this afternoon from Safety Beach. Now, that's where two jet skis are believed to have collided around 2 o'clock this afternoon, leaving that man with leg injuries. He was flown here in a serious but stable condition. Another patient also assessed by paramedics but believed to be in a stable condition. Now, in most parts of Victoria, it has been a good day out on the water. Plenty of people flocking to the Mornington Peninsula and also to our city bay beaches, enjoying seeing some pretty hot conditions, but many making sure they got in before those temperatures soared around the middle of the day. Lots of families there enjoying pretty good water quality at our beaches as well. And for those that didn't want to be outside, they were heading to some ice baths at Elwood Beach, a bit of the best of both worlds there to cool off this morning, or to the ice house in Docklands as well, getting onto the ice at 16 degrees, the air temperature there. So very different to what we're seeing as it nears 40 around the state. Let's take a listen to people as they cool off this afternoon.
Beautiful weather. We've come down early though to beat the extreme heat, but yeah, it's lovely down here.
It's been nice and warm today, so we decided to hit the water. We'll get back to the shade and then crank the AC when we get back home.
Not warm enough. We're happy with the weather. Can't complain.
Just a bit of ice cream, bit of swimming. Good water in the beach, so it's a good day to come out.
Is it good weather or is it getting too hot?
Perfect.
So a pretty good day out in the weather, Alicia. There is some relief on the way this evening, but the temperatures will be climbing again early next week. We'll have more for you at 6 o'clock.
Okay, Penny, thank you. Turning overseas now, and Lisa Marie Presley will be laid to rest alongside her father Elvis at their family estate, Graceland. As US correspondent Alison Petrowski reports, Hollywood continues to pay tribute following her sudden death, aged just 54.
Well, tributes coming in from those who worked on the Elvis biopic, including Aussie director Baz Luhrmann, who took to Instagram today to say, over the last year, the entire Elvis movie family and I have felt the privilege of Lisa Marie's kind embrace. And also Tom Hanks, who played Colonel Tom Parker in the Elvis biopic, he took to Instagram to say that he and his wife Rita Wilson are heartbroken over the loss of Lisa Marie Presley, absolutely broken. Lisa Marie lived her life in the spotlight and we witnessed her go through many high-profile relationships, including her marriage to pop star Michael Jackson and also her brief marriage to actor Nicolas Cage. Nicolas Cage releasing a statement today saying, Lisa had the greatest laugh of anyone I ever met. She lit up every room and I am heartbroken. I find some solace believing she is reunited with her son, Benjamin. Confirmation today that Lisa Marie Presley will be buried in Graceland alongside her father Elvis and also his parents Gladys and Vernon and Elvis's grandmother Minnie Mae. So too she will be buried alongside her son Benjamin, who tragically took his own life in 2020, aged just 27. Those close to Lisa Marie say she never really got over that tragic loss. As of yesterday, Lisa Marie was still the sole owner of Graceland. It is believed that she will hand that ownership over to her three surviving daughters, and it does feel appropriate that she'll be buried alongside her father Elvis, the king of rock and roll, on that property.
Drive-through staff at a McDonald's in the Hunter Valley have come face-to-face with quite a slippery customer clinging to a car. Its occupants believe the snake may have hitched a ride when they stopped in Coffs Harbour 4 hours earlier. A reptile wrangler was called in to safely remove it.